Welcome back, everyone. This is CCP Fozzie, joined by CCP Dolan, and our next match is Stay Frosty, the Pirates versus Providence Wizards. And we've got two very, very similar setups actually coming up here. We've talked a lot about these triple Astarte, Vexer, Inquisitor setups, and both teams have basically taken that and made it their own a little bit. Why don't you tell us a bit about these setups, Dolan?
So both teams have chosen to go with the double logistics frigates to support a large blaster wing here. We have double Astarte on both teams, a little bit of variation in the Link Proteus and the Link Loki, but then a big, strong Vexer wing versus a Sentinel carries more electronic support wing. So those Sentinels are going to be trying to do their tracking disruption, minimize as much damage as possible from the Astartes, and the carries is going to try as hard as he can to keep out what is that? Keep out at least one of the Inquisitors or potentially both.
Yeah, I mean, you can see the story of this match at the beginning. Both teams, by the way, actually started very close to each other as the match now begins. They came in at very close angles. You see the bars down there in the middle of your screen, defense, attack, control. The defense bar much higher for Stay Frosty because of the fact those Vexers have much more hit points than the Sentinels and carries, but the control bar is through the roof for Providence Wizards. And those Sentinels are going to be the key part of this match for them. As you see, they've already put Tracking Disruptors on the Astarte Proteus and other Astarte. This, I think, is going to be one of the big downsides of a setup like what Stay Frosty has brought that we've seen from the tri-team so far. It has no easy way to deal with Sentinels, and yep. Sentinels cripple it so, so badly.
Absolutely. So you can see just you're going to have to, it's really just a toss-up between what's going to mitigate more DPS. So Stay Frosty has a huge advantage in terms of damage as well. Those Vexers bringing as much damage, or nearly as much damage as some of those Astartes, not nearly as much tank though, but they're going to be able to get up and apply their DPS there so much faster as well. Right now, both sides hanging back, making the smart choice, not really wanting to engage.
Yep.
And also, when they do engage, Stay Frosty is going to be at a big disadvantage because those damps are going to keep some of their ships from being able to apply their damage, especially when they're further back in the pack.
Yeah, and those damps are going to be effective against a lot of members of their fleet. Right now, the damps are being applied mainly to the damaged ships, the Proteus and the Vexers, but we're probably going to see those switch to the Inquisitor once the actual battle is joined. The teams right now are very, very cautious, like you said. We are seeing the Providence Wizards team slowly moving towards the Stay Frosty guys, but they're not going to let themselves get caught out of position. This, I think, is both teams playing it correctly, which means we may have what seems like a very simple beginning of the match. Not a lot's going to die right away, but once things actually get going, they're going to get going very fast.
So you can see here, actually, I'm a little bit concerned some of the Stay Frosties. The Stay Frosty Astarte is getting a little bit out in front.
Yep.
And with you can see damage coming in on one of the Inquisitors. What's shooting that? It's the Inquisitor that's way in the back.
He's got drones. He got within warrior range.
He's got a big bunch of...
But that just means
that's so actually, like, Stay Frosty, if they lose this Inquisitor, they're going to have to engage on the control-heavy Providence Wizards team.
So what we're seeing is extremely smart damp control as well from the Providence Wizards team. At the same time they sent those warriors in, they put all of their damps on the Inquisitors, broke their locks, and probably put time damps. There you go. That is a huge, huge, very smart move from Providence Wizards. They basically sniped Inquisitors using drones and damps. That combo together at exactly the same time caught them by surprise. Very, very well played.
So now you can see here they've been forced to engage. There's another Vexer coming in. That might be drone damage as well. Yeah, you can see the ball of drones all on top of him. He's trying to kite back out, trying to apply some warrior damage themselves. But you can see here, like, the Stay Frosty team should have the drone advantage with all those Vexers. But they're just eating warrior twos and not being able to apply damage back due to damps, and just, I don't know, maybe they just have inferior lock range, drone control range skills?
I think it's got to be damps. The big cluster of Valkyrie 2s is still sitting on top of the No Frosty team. It's actually orbiting around one of the Astartes. Looks like they've got them moving in there. So they're charging now across the field. They realize the time is no longer on their side. Stay Frosty is riding as fast as they can across the field to try to get tackle, and they are now on top of the damage dealer for Providence Wizards, but they're getting tackle on the way.
Yeah, they're getting picked off, so they're being screened out, and as they come in, the ships in the back here, some of these Vexers, this Proteus, are receiving those damps and are going to be completely separated in terms of damage from the rest of their team. So it's really up to this Providence Wizards team to chop off that lead wing, get those destroyed as fast as possible, because they really don't have as much damage or tank as the Stay Frosty team, so they need to get on that right now, but nobody's really dropping in Stay Frosty.
No, they sent all of those Vexor drones after the Sentinel. The Sentinel that took some damage of Hell's there, he had a big train of Valkyries after him, but they just weren't keeping up to do enough damage, and it was easily enough damage that could be repped by the Inquisitors.
And there we go. We see Joffe Alksgoo going down in his Vexor here. If he drops out, each one of these Vexors has a tremendous percentage of the damage and combat capability of the Stay Frosty team. Mm-hmm. But meanwhile, an Astarte being traded back, even though he's already catching reps.
He is dropping very fast, so the Vexor is going down. But if that Astarte drops this quickly, that is going to be very good news for the Stay Frosty team. However, he's
meanwhile,
suddenly
so,
slowed
but
way down.
Each of these Vexors that goes down, even especially if they're forced off of the fight, he is catching reps for at least one Inquisitor.
Yep.
The other Inquisitor going down for Stay Frosty, no reps left on that team. And Worm just very low, very low. Is he going to drop here?
Oh, I'm sure he's going to drop, but it's taking him too long. Man, they are doing a good job of keeping him alive for as long as possible. There, now he is gone. So at this point, Stay Frosty knows what they need to do. They need to make this a quick match. They cannot survive long-term because they don't have the reps, and the Providence Wizards team does. The Providence Wizards guys need to use those tracking disruptors to reduce the damage, keep that Loki alive.
Shots coming in on the Link Loki, trying to get those Links off the field. I don't know if that's a smart choice. They really need to get the damage off the field before this Vexor gets eaten because he's already tackled. He's dropping into low armor. That's like they're just losing DPS left and right.
It's going to be all about how long this Loki can survive. At the moment, it's looking very good for him. If you're the Providence Wizards guys, you need to keep the Loki alive, kill both the Vexors fast, get them off the field, and that's going to allow your Astarte and Loki to stay alive.
Additionally, shooting that Loki with Lynx on while your Astartes are already tracking disrupted, maybe not the best choice.
Yeah,
going for the larger hole, the Astarte is going to mean you can apply your damage much better.
Loki is moving through armor. He's at about half armor now, but the Vexor dropping very fast. This Loki would die if this damage keeps up on him. He actually is dropping, but dropping slowly. But once an entire Vector's worth of damage goes off the field, that might be enough to actually keep him alive.
And he's already catching reps. You can see here the tide has turned in reps. He's holding in low armor. Meanwhile, they swapped over to the Astarte of Bogdan. And if he drops, I think the damage is just completely in Providence Wizard's favor at this point.
At this point, look at the control bar. So you see these bars fill up the more of the control is applied. So that control bar for much of the fight was actually fairly empty from Providence Wizards. But it is now full. They have all of their damps, all of their tracking disruptors applied to only three ships.
All of their newts, they're just going to be slamming people down. That Astarte is going to be out of cap in no time.
Yeah.
And they have so much extra that they can actually newt everything on the field here.
These Sentinels, often you don't see the newt bonus being used through much of the match for a Sentinel. They have bonuses to both tracking disruption and to newting, but the newting is often just used to help break tacklers off them, and they're focused on the tracking disrupting. At this point, they feel that they're in a dominant enough position, all the tracking disruption on those three ships, so those Sentinels can just move in and not have to worry about getting shot. They're far too small to get hit by a double tracking disrupted from Sentinel.
And Stay Frosty in a desperation move. Stay Frosty is making the only move they really can here is that's to shoot down Madchef's Astarte and hope that they have enough tank to carry them through the rest of the match. Force maybe the Loki or one of these Sentinels or carries to come in close, but they really won't. They can just walk away. They can just fly everything away, keep the Loki off, and they win on points.
Yeah, like Ryze said, this is actually is a smart move. I mean, they're in a desperate situation. It's not going to work, it looks like. But if they had kept shooting at the Loki, nothing would have happened. So their hope in this case would have been that they could catch the Astarte off balance. Maybe it wouldn't actually be very heavily tanked. Sometimes you don't know how the enemies fit. They could actually just have very low tank and be full damage. But in this case, it's tanking just fine. So that was their last real hope dashed. And now we are going to be seeing Providence Wizards victorious over Stay Frosty, and our friendly neighborhood pirates are going to be eliminated from this new Eden Open. However, for a first time performance, they've been very respectable.
Yep, exactly. I'm sort of still questioning the choice of the Loki over the Astarte. So at that point in the match, they had two Astartes and the Proteus left. Mm-hmm. Getting Loki Links off the field isn't going to really help them because under no circumstances are they going to catch the Sentinels or the Inquisitors. They're never going to even get close.
Yeah.
Plus, he's not really doing as much damage. He has those Links in the highs. Mm-hmm. He won't have many guns. And then the Astarte is going to be on top of them anyway. He's easy target to shoot at. He's already in there applying his damage. You have to apply your damage back, and you're not going to be able to mitigate that Ewar in any way by killing that Loki down.
Yeah, I agree.
Loki doesn't have information, right?
It does not. No, it has everything but information. I agree that it's a tough choice. The one kind of thing that might give you a reason to shoot at the Loki is that the Astarte has resistances that are very strong against blasters.
That's true.
The Loki, not so much. So it actually probably would have had an easier time breaking through the resistances, assuming that both the Astarte and Loki are equally tanked. Mm-hmm. But obviously, it just wasn't enough. They did come close. If they'd kept those Vexors alive, either one of those Vexers been alive for another 30 seconds,
yeah,
it actually probably would have been enough.
Yeah, exactly.
But they dropped fast enough. Providence Wizards doing the right thing. Like, I've actually been very impressed by their setups. They have brought a lot of very similar stuff to this with command ships, tech threes, hacks. They brought the Sacrilege and Damnation team. They brought the Absolution teams.
Who is the comic book character that when he gets killed by someone, he like evolves to like be stronger against him? He's like Armageddon or something like that. Maybe Providence has been harassed and
so much
by
yeah.
so many people that every time that someone comes and messes with them, they just adapt and become mm-hmm. they're going to become an ultra creature, unbeatable in every way.
That is the match now over. Stay Frosty is now out of the tournament. We'll see them, I'm sure, again in future Alliance tournaments and New Eden Opens. And Providence Wizards moves their way through the loser's bracket.
Yep. And we will see you back in just a few seconds.